Hey YouTube, you said you wanted to talk. What's up? Why do you go around making other people look stupid? What do you mean?
What's water made of?
Water?
Yeah. What makes water?
Water.
Okay, what elements does it take to make water?
H2O.
So what does that mean?
That it's water.
Okay, so that was one example. Really?
So carbon dioxide, you know, everything emits carbon dioxide, you know, trees, human beings, animals.
So the trees are contributing to the...
Oh, definitely. But it's, definitely. So, yeah. So, well, trees are, I guess, the, you know, one of the original primary sources of emitters of CO2. So trees, you know, trees are just like anything else on this earth that emits carbon dioxide.
I could do this all day.
Enough.
You know what I think? I think you do it to make yourself look superior.
Oh yeah, maybe that's it. Maybe I'm just a giant egotistical jerk who delights in humiliating other people. Well, that fact certainly hasn't gone unnoticed by your viewers. You come across a little condescending in these interviews. You basically set up every single question to make other people look like idiots. This guy is a pretentious douchebag. Now that's hurtful. I hate this YouTube channel. It makes every single person it interviews look like a complete retard. Not everyone's a physicist, so get the fuck over it.
Stop, all right? My viewers don't own me. Actually, you should have read those T's and C's a little more carefully.
By seeing your ads, your viewers do, in fact, own you.
Oh man.
Yeah, now, come on, just between you and me, how closely do you have to pick through those interviews to make people look that dumb? I mean, some of them.
If you want to see the complete interviews, then why don't you click the annotation and you can judge for yourself. Did you ever think that the reason that I start with the misconceptions is because I wrote my PhD on how to design films to teach physics? And I found that if you just say the correct stuff,
trees get most of their mass from carbon dioxide. Yep, pretty much covers it.
Viewers don't actually learn anything. They just feel like they're learning and become more confident in the things that they thought beforehand.
So what you're saying is you make people look stupid so that you can teach others. How noble.
But that's just it. I don't think these people are stupid. There's a difference between being unknowledgeable and being unintelligent. I mean, I'm unknowledgeable about lots of stuff. And science can be hard for the particular reason that it's counterintuitive. So I think we should acknowledge what everyone's thinking, what most people are thinking, and use that as our basis for teaching.
But if you actually believe that, why does your face light up with glee every time you hear a misconception?
Because in that moment, I realize that I can be useful. I can help people learn the truth. And that's the point of Veritasium, to help people understand the truth of the natural world and to get them to seek the truth in their own lives. As Richard Feynman said, the first principle is that you must not fool yourself, and you are the easiest person to fool.
This guy is a pretentious douchebag.